Hey everyone, my name is Ronak, back with another video, and this is 13th video in the Getting Started with Machine Learning playlist. And in this video you are going to learn the confusion matrix. So let's get started. So what is confusion matrix? The field of machine learning and specifically the problem of statistical classification, confusion matrix, also known as an error matrix, is a specific table layout that allows visualization of the performance of an algorithm, typically a supervised learning one. So once again, a formal definition I would say. So in easy words, it is a graphical representation of differences in actual values and predicted values. So whenever we have to measure the loss in the classification, we have an advantage because values are discrete, and discrete values can be differentiated very really easily between one of the actual classes and predicted classes. So in any machine learning model, what we do is training and testing. Here in our example, we are just not following the laws entirely, but we will be just focusing on the confusion matrix itself. We predicting my model over the same data itself. And then we have Y data and we have the Y predicted data. Then we can compare and find out the differences. So it requires four building blocks, which is true positives, true negatives, false positives, false negatives. So true positives, let us start with true positives. This is the case where the actual positive value and the predicted positive values are same. So if I have one in my actual value and if I get predicted value as also one, it gives me true positive. Then we have true negatives. In the case where the actual value is also negative, that is zero, and the predicted negative value is also zero, then we have false positives. In this case where we have actually negative values, actual negative values, so my Y is going to be actual negative value and my predicted, that is my Y pred, is going to be positive. Similarly, we have false negatives. In this case we have actual positive values, but the machine learning algorithm is predicting negative values. This is the graphical representation of what you are learning, that is the confusion matrix. So on the left side we have actual values which have positive values and negative values. In the predicted we have positive and negative. So this is classification specific. Regression confusion matrix doesn't work for the regression, keep that in mind. Now this is the example that we have learned. So number of hours a particular student spends. So we are referring our logistic regression classifier with the confusion matrix, although many other classifiers can work very well with the confusion matrix. Not an issue. So first let us start with the true positives. So true positives are that we have both the values, okay? So the Y and the Y pred are exactly same, yielding one, that is true positive. Then we have true negative, where the Y is yielding zero but the true positive is also yielding zero. Then we have false positives. So false positives are my Y actually doesn't have any, like it is predicting negative but my Y pred says it is positive, so we get false positives. So the prediction is false and it is related, and the prediction is saying positives. And finally we have false negatives, so it is zero, okay, because we don't have any space for it. But basically false negatives is that my Y is one and my algorithm says it is zero, so that is false negatives. If we put these values, so these are 3, 1, 2, and 0, and we get this one. So we just replace it where they are needed. Yeah, now let us look at the implementation of this thing. So this is the basic logistic regression stuff. If you don't know this one, this was in the 12th tutorial. I'll just put the link in the description below, and I'll also link a card so that you can just look at the implementation of basic logistic regression if you don't know. Like any classifier can be used for the confusion matrix, but we are considering our logistic regression example. Now let's get started. So this is the code. Let me get you sorted with the font. So this is my data. I'm making my data. Then I take the mean. Then I take the length. Then there is this class logistic regression where beta naught and beta 1 are the weights. I find the logistic regression. Then for the prediction, I apply the sigmoid function. So this sigmoid function is basically going to yield the values, the predicted probabilities, based on which of those lie above my threshold. Okay. And now let's get started. So here now I'll start making the changes for the confusion matrix. So what I'll be needing is an array, basically. So that array is going to give me my true positive, true negative, false positive, false negative. All these four values, I want them easily. So yeah, let's get started. So what I'll do is here, I'll first of all make an array. So basically that array is going to give me the Y predicted value, okay? So I'll say Y pred is equal to np dot array. So for now, I'm keeping it as a blank array, and then we will start. Now, what I'll do is I'll make a for loop over here. So I'll just get rid of this one. I'm just cutting this. So what I'll say is for I n range of n. Yeah, so we have it. So basically we are setting the threshold that if my sigmoid value, but I'll have to also iterate it. Okay. So what I'll do is, since I'll be testing, I'm using these values. So I'm going to iterate through my entire sigmoid function. So here I can say self.yprad. So basically I'll be using the yprad that I've declared. And the way I do it is, I'll just append, okay? So I'll say np.append, and here I'll say, so append function takes two parameters. So I'll say self.yprad, and then I'll be feeding it one. Similarly, I'll repeat the same for this. Let me just copy this thing. Yeah, we have it. So it is going to iterate through my sigmoid function, and then it is going to give me this output. The next step, so I'll say self.yprad. So I'll say confusion matrix, that is the name of my function. And now this confusion matrix is going to have the true positives, true negatives, false positive, false negatives. So I'll just declare them over here, because I'm going to use this same algorithm, and basically the same concept, I would say, in all of my upcoming videos. Yeah, we have it. Now, over here, I'll start with the function. So again, I'll make a for loop. So for I in range of n, I want to perform something. So what I'll be doing is, so I'll say if, so first of all, I'll start with the true positive. So I'll say y, if y of I is equal to 1, and self.yprad, so that is my variable that holds my array. So self.yprad of I is equal to 1. I want to perform something. So I'll say true positives plus equal to 1. So this indicates that I want to perform it. Then I'll similarly say if y of I is equal to 0 and self dot yprad of I is equal to 0. So both are 0. Then my true negatives play the role. So I'll say true negatives is equal to 0. So it I'm actually iterating it. So this is one. And then I'll say if y of I is equal to 1 and self dot yprad of I is equal to 0. So this is false negatives. So I'll say false negatives plus 1 equal to 1. Then we have it, and then I can lastly if y of I is equal to 0 and self dot yprad of I is equal to 1. So this is false positives plus and equal to 1, and then I kick out of the for loop. Now let me make a matrix. So I'll say matrix is equal to np dot array, and this is going to take my four parameters. So basically true positives, and on the right side that is the matrix of the matrix to the right of the first one, that is 1 1 and 1 2. So first row, second column, I always have false negatives, and on the second row, first column, I have false positives, and lastly I have true negatives. So I'll say true negatives, and finally I'll say dot reshape into 2 by 2, and yeah, we are done. And now I'll just say return matrix. I'll be returning the matrix. That's it. This is the confusion matrix. And now here I'll say model, that is the name of my object. I'll say logistic regression. And now I'll be performing it. So I'll say model.fit going to take two parameters x and y. Let me print those. So I'll get the values of the beta naught and beta 1, and then I'll say print model dot predict, because it is going to give me the sigmoid function. And here also I say x because it takes one parameter, that is x. And lastly I'll say model dot confusion matrix. We have it, and we get an error. Let's check the error. Local variable true negative, self reference before assignment. So I'll have to just say self to all of these because I've declared them outside my functions. The reason I've declared them outside the function is because just for the future tutorial, that is precision recall and F1 score. Yeah, and we get it. So this is our array, like we calculated in the PPT, that is 3, 0, 2, and 1, just like this one. So exactly we get the same array. So this is the way we do the confusion matrix, and now I'll show you the scikit way. So basically this is the basic fitting rule. So sklearn.linear model import, I'll just import my logistic regression, that is my classifier, and then I'll say lr, that is the name of the variable I call it, so logistic regression. And there are going to be a little bit of deviations, I'll tell you why. lr.fit I would say x comma y, and then I'll say y pred is equal to lr.predict. So prediction is going to be done on the same x, and it gives me 00, 000, 0011. So basically this is using the L2 regularization, and I'm not actually able to disable it. I actually tried it earlier. So if I say penalty is equal to none, it doesn't make difference at all. Okay, so we have calculated it in the raw form using all the beta naught and beta 1, and exactly the same procedure that we have, but here the regularization is by default. It is using the two parameters, the cross validation and regularization. And now I can say from sklearn dot matrix import, so import confusion matrix, and this confusion matrix is going to take two parameters. So confusion matrix takes y and y pred, and we get it. So it is 3003, because it is 100%, that is first are 3 and first, just like our example. If it would have been the predicted values, we would have got the different answer, that is the one we have calculated. So I'll say from sklearn.matrix import plot confusion matrix. So basically I can plot the confusion matrix, that is one of the features that the scikit is actually providing us. So here I'll say matplotlib. So matplotlib is basically one of the packages, so you can install it. So I'll say import matplotlib.pyplot as plt, and now I can so basically I've imported the plt system of it, and now I can say plot confusion matrix, then my classifier is lr, and then I'll be feeding it x and y, and here I'll say plt.show, and it gives me a nice matrix of the above example. So this is it for this tutorial. So this is the most introductory and really easy concept, okay, and this is the basis I would say for the precision recall and F1 score that we are going to learn in the future tutorials. Okay, thank you for watching. Goodbye.